Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa echoing the Justice Secretary's sentiments. The former Philippine Police Chief says Fortun's findings can be investigated by the NBI. This as he again asserts the Philippines' justice system is working.
Kung totoo yung findings ni Fortun, ipapile. May NBI naman tayo nagkakandak ng investigation. I-file yan. Kaya nga, nag-investigya siya para magkakuha tayo ng ebidensya, i-file dito sa ating korte, hindi doon sa ICC dahil nga wala sila jurisdiction sa atin. Bakit? Nag-file ba si Fortun sa ICC? I-file nga dito sa korte natin. Kasi kung doon ka sa ICC, parang sinampal yung ating kasarinlan, yung ating soberenya.
De La Rosa, the chief implementer of the Duterte administration's drug war, also made this bold remark if he's proven guilty by Philippine courts.
You can hang me in front of the Filipino people. You can hang me through the decision of our Filipino courts. But by God, not by a foreigner.
Environmental groups condemn the violent dispersal of residents and anti-mining groups on Sibuyan Island, Romblon. Two were hurt in the dispersal, which police assert was done to maintain peace and order. Anjo Bagawisan reports.
Tensions flared at the island of Sibuyan in the province of Romblon Friday as residents and anti-mining groups barricaded a mining company's operations there. Police formed their own barricade to keep the groups from blocking three trucks of the mining firm, which residents say were allegedly hauling nickel ore extracted in the area by Altai Mining Philippines Corporation and bringing them to a private port. The protesters and police clashed as the trucks approached. The police line finally held them off, enabling the trucks to pass. But the anti-mining group say at least two people were wounded. 22-year-old resident Angie Romero, a councilman of Barangay España, whose shirt was torn in the commotion and who was handcuffed by the police.
Pinilak po ako ng police, ma'am, at saka pinusasan po ako. Wala naman akong violation, ma'am, na ginawa.
From the very start kasi, sir, yung tao yun na yun, sir, is mataas na, sir, yung kanyang boses. Parang ang init-init yun, sir. Kung ano-ano na sinasabi, sir, sa police. Tapos kaya kung nagkaroon na, sir, ng medyo nagtatulakan na, sir, ganyan, sir, ay napusasan siya ng police para lang, sir, masubdue pa, sir. Masubdue lang siya, sir. Then after mga ilang segundo lang naman yun, sir, ay tinanggal din po agad yung posas.
Environmental groups who feared the impact of mining activity on the island's ecosystem deplored law enforcement's handling of the dispersal.
Hindi namin ito naranasan sa loob ng aming pamumuhay dito sa isla. Never in our lives na nagkaroon ng ganito na magpapadala ng mga pulis at magpapadala ng mga sundalo na kami lamang ay ina-assert namin ng aming karapatan para sa malinis, sa sustainable, sa balanse, na may ecological balance ang aming mga pamumuhay.
Officials of Barangay España, one of the two villages affected by the mining operation, said they were not consulted in the construction of the private port.
Walang kinuhang permit sa barangay na kung saan ito ang port na ginawa nila ay nasasakupan po ng Barangay España. At si Miura mismo nagsabi na hindi niya alam na mayroong port na itinayo yung Altai Mining. Kaya nga, masasabi ko na talagang illegal yung pagpatpatayo.
Local police say the road is a public highway, which is why cops helped the trucks pass through. They assert they had no orders to treat the protesters violently.
Wala po kaming pinapanigan, hindi po kami nakakumakampi sa mining company at hindi rin kami kumakampi sa anti-mining. Ang Altai, sir, is meron po silang permit, sir, to operate. Kasama po yun, sir, sa exploration permit nila, sir. Ang nag-issue nun, sir, is national.
Since July 2022, Altai Philippines Mining Corporation has resumed exploration activities in Sibuyan Island. Back in 2011, the Philippine Environment Department's Geosciences Bureau issued a cease and desist order against Altai following a complaint by the local government of San Fernando. But the order was reversed in 2021 following an appeal by the mining firm. The current mayor says Altai has permits from the Mines and Geosciences Bureau, as well as the Philippine Ports Authority and Bureau of Customs to ship the extracted materials.
Wala pong jurisdiction si LGU na ibigay yung hinihingi nila na business permit at saka yung barangay clearance na kukunin po sa kanilang mga barangay. Kasi po, ito po ay galing sa national at part po ito ng kanilang exploration process.
The mining firm has yet to release a statement on the incident. Environment Secretary Tony Yulo Loizaga on Thursday assured the agency will take a good look into the mining situation in Sibuyan, considered the Galapagos of the Philippines. Groups affected by the dispersal are studying legal action. They call on lawmakers to probe the mining issue and the Environment Department to heed the concerns of residents. They also urged the Interior Department and Commission on Human Rights to inspect the area. The anti-mining group's barricade remains at Sibuyan Island, with protesters vowing to stay there as long as mining operations continue. Anjo Bagawisan, ABS-CBN News.